Nazi.
Beginning, I'll give you a quick overview of the Pacific and the traditional superpowers who have been in the Pacific over the years. Then I will go into the bulk of my seminar, which is about the key demographic, which is population issues, economic issues, geopolitical, cultural, and historical aspects of the four largest Melanesian countries. I will then look at Chinese aid to Fiji, the form that is coming in, the positives about Chinese aid, also some of the negatives that we see at the moment in Fiji and the Pacific, some of the drawbacks. I will talk about China's influence on the super rivalry in the Pacific and how China has changed the nature of the superpower rivalry. And I'll give a brief sort of, you know, our small perspective from Fiji on the future for China in the Pacific. And there was a time, of course, you know, when there was hysteria in the Pacific about the Japanese penetration into the Pacific, buying properties like that in Australia, New Zealand, Fiji, etc. Today, Japan is not feared anymore. Nobody fears Japan and the Japanese. They're part of the donut club in the Pacific. And all that remains, you know, in Fiji are the quality brand names from Japan, like Toyota and Toshiba and all that. And they also have some very, very good aid projects in the Pacific. They help our university, you know, with an ITC center. We actually are quite friendly, you know, with Japan. We don't fear Japan anymore. And, you know, my feeling, you know, is that, you know, the Chinese empire is now emerging throughout the world. You know, and of course, it is an empire. And it will become, you know, within 10 years, it will become the most powerful country in the world. It will dominate the IMF, World Bank, World Trade Organization, ADB, and all that. And also your Chinese products, you know, will be everywhere in the world. Your aid will be everywhere in the world. Your investment will be everywhere in the world. Just like American products, investment, aid, and so on, was everywhere in the world, you know, in the 1960s and 70s, and Japanese products and investments were everywhere in the world, 80s and 90s. So also will the Chinese investment products and things will be everywhere in the world. And with your products and with your investments will also go your culture. I think as you mature as an empire, you know, you also will apply standards to yourself. And I, listening to some of the speakers who've been talking, you know, here with the Confucius Institute directors, you can see that already, you know, Chinese government is talking about being good, you know, in its policies, you know, abroad. And I hope that, you know, that will happen. And, you know, small and tiny Pacific Island countries like ours, with 1,400 people, with 5,000 people, with 500,000 people, I hope that we'll continue to gain from our friendship with a more developmental and considerate partner, you know, like China. Thank you very much.